little update on the Jeep today.
Yes.
We've been hearing a clicking sound. And I really thought it was the control arms. Because if you see, they're popped. And that one too. And the one over there. And I barely have a year with them. Supposedly they last forever. They will never pop. And so the guy at the shop that I took it, I mean, I've been knowing the shop for a long time. They've been fixing cars with me and everything. I know them. They're really nice people. But probably they didn't know these are not supposed to be greased. I feel like they put grease on them and that's the reason they pop. But so that one's popped, this one's popped. And then the other side is popped too, I can see it. But again, back to the clicking, it's not that. And I thought I was like, okay, it's probably these, but they're not, they're still good. These are good too. And I keep looking around. I even put my GoPro on the bottom and nothing. And after I look, it was the brakes. This brakes. Let me see it. Oh, I don't think it could. Look at that. God damn. Look at that. Yeah, those are done. They're thin. Really thin. So yeah, I'm gonna go through my brakes. And then I'm gonna change the tires. I got 35s. And they're nice. They're beautiful. They make the car look really beautiful. But it's my daily car. This Jeep is my daily. I don't have another car. And drive this to work. I basically take it anywhere. And so I'm done with the 35s. I will go with 33s. Because again, they're fucking gas heaters. I mean, I should be known. Like, since I bought the Jeep, it was already a gas heater. But with 35s, it makes it worse. And a lot of people want to go 40s and shit higher, but not me. I'm good. I'm fucking good. If I had another car, then yeah, for sure, I'll keep it like this. But I'm gonna go lower on the tires. So it's just like a quick update of the Jeep I'm gonna be doing. Again, I probably have to buy another one of these. I don't know if I can still drive it like that. I mean, they're both pop. They pop the bottom and the top one. I pop, and then one side of that side is popped. So let me get closer. Oh, I can see it. No, not that one. That one's good. That one didn't get greased up. Oh, I guess it did it. I thought it was popped. But I guess it's only those two. But I don't know. I don't know if I could drive it like this. And if I could, I'd be sick. I'm gonna buy another ones. I kind of do want to buy another ones. So I don't want to risk it if I end up getting dry and stuff goes in there. But yeah. Right now I'm doing, not for this video, for another video I'll make, about lights. I already see it. I see the lights. And I'm probably not gonna show it in that video, but I'm gonna show it in this one. I did fucked up and I ended up cutting the wrong one. And so now I have to solder it and connect it right. So yeah. Looks like I said, it's a little quick update. It's not that much. I'm not doing that much to it right now. Cause I'm going to Disney with the family and I don't want really do too much stuff right now. And I wish I could just take this Jeep to Disney, but I don't think we'll make it. So, probably rent a car or something. But yeah. Oh, and then what else thing? I don't know if you guys know. If you guys know, I'd be love if you guys leave it down in the comments. I've been getting a leak down here by the transmission. I have to get there. But I've been seeing videos. I don't know if it's true or not. But hold on, let me get in there. Let me get something. Hold up. There we go. Alright. Look at this. So I would love to someone would know what's really going on. I don't know if it's the transmission or the engine, but you can tell it's falling from here. You see little drops of oil and it's going down the back. I mean, I check anywhere, cables, everything, and nothing. I don't see no leak. I don't see nothing. So I saw a video. Paul says the oil filter from on top. I really don't know. I'm a rookie of this the Jeep life. Someone is a veteran of this. Paul, you will know. But I've been looking for that oil leak and I haven't found it. So I even took it to the gang, the same guy that I got my this thing fixed, and he ain't find anything either. So yeah, if someone knows what's really going on, I would love to just leave it down in the comment really what it is, and that'd be nice. I guess I don't know if it's something really really bad and then it'll mess up my engine or the transmission. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Nothing bad here. So yeah. Get out of there. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Right now I'm trying to finish that video and upload this one. Probably you're gonna see this one before that one. But yeah. Oh, and then the headlights. I kinda wanna change the headlights. I know I barely have a year with them, but they suck. They really suck. I mean, you can see, but it just, I would love to if this one, instead of lighting this one, because if you get this one, the top one lights up, not the bottom one. So I thought this one was the high beams and this one was the low beams, but no, this is the low. This is the
90% of the time, I have no idea what the fuck I'm talking about.
The high, but fucking confused now. This is the low beams and this is the high beams. I know it sounds really stupid, but they should just put the low beams here and the high beams on top. But again, it's not. It's the low beams on top, high beams on the bottom. And I'm fucking flashing everybody. Everybody. So I feel like I'm making them blind when I put the lights on. So that's why I don't even run this ones. I run the bottom ones. And I know I'm not supposed to do that, but so that's the reason I'm gonna change them. So I don't know if you guys recommend a couple of nice lights. I would love to you guys leave it down in the comments. These ones are fucking perfect. I got no complaints on these ones. They are a little dirty, but these are perfect. I like these ones a lot. But yeah, thank you for watching this video and have a beautiful day or night.